Hello, my name is Jon Wallace, and I'm speaking to you today on behalf of Hyperacusis Central. I just wanted to take a moment to introduce you to what hyperacusis is, how you might be able to protect your own ears, and how you might be able to help those of us that are suffering. So for starters, what is hyperacusis? If you Google it, it'll probably say something like a sensitivity to everyday sounds. But the kind that I have, this subset, and that my peers and friends who are also suffering have, is really called pain hyperacusis. What this means is that sounds essentially are louder, much louder, and they cause pain, actual physical pain, often a stabbing pain, a burning pain, aches in the ear and on the facial region, on the jaw. It is as bad as it sounds. If you've ever had an earache before, just imagine that multiplied and with burning. And unfortunately, even a moderate version of hyperacusis is quite debilitating, but we have some participants and sufferers who are have a severe or catastrophic nature, can't even leave their houses. And these are not older people who lost their hearing. Most of them that I know are very young. I've got some white beard hairs here, but I'm 42. I know people in their 20s with this condition, never got to get their career started, start a family. I know young single mothers with this condition who have trouble tolerating the sounds of their own children. And I can tell you, someone who's been through a good number of things in my life, this pain is different. This pain is not the type of thing you can tough out, that you can tough your way through. It completely puts you down. It completely halts your life. And unfortunately, the pain from sound can last days, weeks, months, sometimes permanent. So it's not a well-known condition, but the suffering that we see from it is rather extreme. How does something like this happen? The primary cause is noise-related, a loud acoustic trauma, like a gunshot being next to a firework. It can even be duration-oriented, like being at a very loud event for too long. We also see medicinal causes, like a bad reaction to an antibiotic, or viral causes. We even see some structural causes, like from a concussion, or an injury from an assault. You would think that we could piece all this together and find a cure or some therapeutics to help, as indeed earplugs and headphones and Pelter earmuffs, they only do so much for us. I can tell you personally that I have all the ear protection in the world, and it's still very hard for me to not be in pain from sounds once I leave the house, and I try my best. I was a very social guy, had an awesome life living in New York, and I am still fighting to get that life back, but it's all been very drastically changed for me. So we talked about what it is, we talked about the causes. Certainly on the noise insult front, that's how you can protect yourself. If you pay attention to the guidelines associated with hearing loss and to some degree associated with tinnitus, if you're at a really loud football stadium and you're next to the announcement speaker, you might want to protect yourself. If you're at a concert that's extremely loud, you're by the speaker, it might be a good idea to wear some earplugs. I know it's not that cool. I used to be a musician for years myself. Used to go out with friends. Nothing too cool about putting earplugs in, but I can tell you I would give anything to go back in time and protect my ears and just be responsible about it. Another key component in this conversation I'm having with you today is with how rare this condition is, and how many people don't know about it, including doctors. There is so much room for us to do more in studying this condition and funding dollars towards research. It's not the type of thing that's been exhausted and studied up and down and there's nothing we can do. We can actually make a difference here. We can get our lives back. I think the answers exist. There are ways within the middle ear and the inner ear and auditory nerve, I believe that we can figure out a way to not have pain from sound and be able to get back to living our lives. And please check out hyperacusisresearch.org for more information on the condition, as well as a way to donate should you be inspired. Also, hyperacusiscentral.org is a great resource for personal testimonies and more about pain hyperacusis. Thank you for your time listening to this. Please do help us. Please take a moment, and God bless.